hurricane track forecasts have improved quite a bit over the years. And I think that's largely due to the fact that track is governed by the large-scale winds. And larger scales tend to be easier to predict. Storm intensity, though, is much more complicated because it depends on a range of scales, all the way from those same very large scales down to much smaller scales, say the scale of individual rain bands, and some would even argue down to the scale of individual raindrops. HS-3 uses two of NASA's unmanned Global Hawk aircraft. These aircraft are capable of flying at high altitudes above the storms. A typical science flight will be about 26 hours. That means we can take off from the east coast of the United States, fly all the way out to the Cape Verde Islands off of Africa, fly around for about 4 to 6 hours, and then return. We're looking at the relative roles of the environment through which the storms move, and then also what's happening in the interior of the storms, and how those two interact to lead to storm intensification. And so we designed the payloads on the Global Hawks to really tackle one or the other. So on one Global Hawk that we call our environmental Global Hawk, we have a set of three instruments that take measurements of environmental temperature, relative humidity, pressure, and wind speed and wind direction. On the overstorm aircraft, we have a set of instruments that are really geared toward precipitation and winds within the storm. The ideal storm for us is a storm that comes off Africa, looks promising, has a nice interaction potentially with the Saharan air layer, moves north of the Caribbean islands and becomes a major hurricane, and then recurves and moves northward out in the central Atlantic, where it's far away from land but provides us with a good laboratory for getting measurements and really understanding the more significant storms, which are the major hurricanes.